It's time for another WrestlePlanet news update, as we have news on the AEW status of Cody Rhodes, a WWE superstar has undergone a shocking name change, and Jon Moxley's AEW return has been made official. And before we get into it, make sure you help me out and drop a like on the video and subscribe to see if we can get to 30,000 subscribers before the end of January, as many of you watching aren't subscribed to the channel, and yes, I'm talking to you. Let's start with a potential new signing heading to WWE, as they have shown interest in an independent wrestling star. According to Fightful, WWE have strong interest in bringing in former Ring of Honor Women's Champion Roxy following a recent tryout. Roxy would recently try out at the Performance Center ahead of her departure from ROH, and is said to have performed well, and there was a significant push within the company to get her signed even before that. One Performance Center source pointed to Roxy's main event match with Deonna Purrazzo on Impact recently as evidence of the hiring being a no-brainer. In the title versus title match, Roxy's ROH title was on the line, as was Purrazzo's AAA Reina del Reina's belt, with the latter eventually being crowned the double champion. Roxy began training as a wrestler at the age of 13, and it seems that the now 20-year-old's future lies in WWE going forward following her title loss. Over recent weeks, the current Ring of Honor Tag Team Champions, the Briscoes, have been locked in a war of words with AEW's FTR following a brawl at the recent ROH Final Battle event. The collision led to speculation that Mark and Jay could be AEW bound following the hiatus of Ring of Honor, with both men no longer under contract. They would appear on Busted Open Radio this week, where they discussed potentially signing with AEW, and Jay would say, "That's the thing, man, if it does happen, when and if, everybody else is going to have to take a back seat. That's just going to be the way it is. Once we get in there, y'all know what we're going to do. Once they see us in FTR and we whoop their ass, they're gonna have no choice but to put us regularly on their television program. I think once we make that splash, they're going to want to see it again and again, so I ain't really too worried about that. At the end of the day, we're providing for our families, so we've got to do what we've got to do, but I don't think we've got to worry about riding the bench." Whilst AEW President Tony Khan recently confirmed that nothing is official regarding a move for the Briscoes, he did have a ton of praise for the Ring of Honor mainstays. The Briscoes are not only the ROH Tag Champions, but they are also currently holding the GCW Tag Titles and have issued an open challenge for this weekend's The World on GCW event inside the Hammerstein Ballroom, with many expecting FTR to answer the call this Saturday night. Whether they will or not is unknown, but you can find out if they do by purchasing the pay-per-view using our Fight affiliate link in the description below if you want to show some support for both GCW and WrestlePlanet. In December 2021, Jeff Hardy would be released from WWE, which immediately led to speculation of a Hardy Boys reunion, with Jeff rumoured to be following his brother to All Elite Wrestling. Whilst no AEW appearance has been confirmed, Big Time Wrestling today confirmed that the Hardy Brothers will be linking up on a tour of shows in March, starting on Saturday the 12th in Webster, Massachusetts. The promotion would take to Twitter to say, "Hardy Boys team for the first time in 3 years, Saturday, March 12th, Webster, Mass. More tour dates to come." This will be the first time Matt and Jeff have teamed together since an April 2019 house show in Madison, Wisconsin, where they would successfully defend their WWE SmackDown tag titles against the Usos. This was 11 days after they won the belts on an episode of SmackDown, with the Hardys vacating the titles shortly after due to a Jeff Hardy injury during an attack by Lars Sullivan. Jeff will remain under his non-compete clause until Wednesday, 9th of March, and will appear in Big Time Wrestling just 3 days later. Next up, we have a quick clarification on a story that we ran yesterday after it appeared that Peter Avalon's AEW contract had came to an end. This week, Avalon would reveal that he is now open to all independent bookings, which seemed to suggest that his deal with All Elite Wrestling had came to an end, and he would specifically state that he is open for bookings any date, any time, and any place. This did make it seem that he would have no prior engagements. However, his former manager Lever Bates would respond to a fan on Twitter asking if Avalon had indeed departed AEW, to which Lever responded, "No, he's still there, just adding indie dates." Despite recent reports stating that his deal was coming to an end, it seems that for now he'll remain with the company whilst also working outside independent shows. Former WWE Champion Kofi Kingston would appear on the Battleground podcast this week, where he would discuss a potential match between the New Day and a certain AEW faction. Following the announcement of Impact Knockouts champion Mickie James's appearance in the Royal Rumble this year, Kofi would be asked if he and his stablemates have ever discussed a match with wrestlers outside of WWE. He would then go on to reference a 2018 video game showdown with Kenny Omega and the Young Bucks at E3, before saying that the New Day wants a match against the Elite, and Kofi would say, "Absolutely, we talk about working with the Elite all the time. We talk about having a six-man tag match with the Elite. That would be great. We kind of touched it when we played them in Street Fighter at E3 in 2018. That wasn't supposed to happen. We were surprised that we got the approval from WWE. We thought at some point it would get pulled, you know? We were expecting to be told, wait a minute, we don't know who these guys are. You can't be out there socializing and acknowledging people from other universes. But here we are, man, it's crazy. It's a great thing for us to be openly crossing bridges and opening forbidden doors. It's really exciting." Kofi would go on to state that he hopes that more doors will open in the future in terms of WWE crossing over with other promotions beyond Mickie James's appearance. The Young Bucks would in fact change their Twitter bio last year, stating that one day they will wrestle New Day, reminiscent of a tweet predicting a match between themselves and the Revivals years prior. Of course, the Bucks would eventually work with the now FTR in AEW, so perhaps the New Day prediction isn't so far-fetched. Next, we have an update on the AEW status of the TNT champion Cody Rhodes, whose contract recently expired with the company. Whilst the news of his contract ending has led to speculation on his future, Rhodes is set to appear on tonight's episode of AEW Dynamite, his first appearance in a few weeks. During his absence, an interim AEW TNT champion was crowned, with Sammy Guevara holding claim to being the champion of that network. Whilst Cody hasn't been on TV this year, he did travel to Newark 2 weeks ago to be involved with that Dynamite taping. However, due to a family medical issue, he had to go home early. This is said to be the reason for his deal expiring, with him being unable to sign a new contract that day. This means that he may well be signing it today or tonight, the first time that he'll be at an AEW event this year. Dave Meltzer would also stamp out any speculation of a surprise Cody appearance in the Royal Rumble after reports of a Forbidden Door surprise in the match. Dave would also rule out an appearance in the Rumble from Jon Moxley as well, which led to CM Punk jokingly asking Meltzer if he himself was in the Rumble, as he was working on his calendar at the time. With that said though, it looks like we could have some news on a new Cody Rhodes AEW contract within even the next few hours, so make sure you stay subscribed for any upcoming news updates. Last night on NXT 2.0, a popular star would seemingly reveal that he has undergone a new name change. Former NXT UK champion Walter would defeat Roderick Strong in the main event of the show, before interrupting the ring announcer and declared that the winner of the match was Gunther instead of his usual name Walter. The show then went off the air with his faction Imperium brawling with Strong's Diamond Mine. Interestingly, this follows a recent trademark filing from WWE for the term Gunther Stark, which was filed on January 13th. It appears that WWE didn't do their research, however, as this is also the name of a Nazi U-boat commander who served in World War II. It appears that this would have been the original planned name for Walter, although it's likely WWE will now drop the Stark part of the name due to the lack of awareness on their part, as well as the backlash from fans that followed. As we've discussed previously, Walter is now working as part of the main NXT roster, having recently moved to the United States, leaving the NXT UK brand behind. Walter's former colleague Keith Lee, who knows all about WWE name changes, would take to Twitter and seemingly agrees with the poor fan reaction and said, "Man, if what I'm hearing is real, poor Walter." YouTube channel Cultaholic would have the most liked comment on the clip of the incident uploaded to YouTube by WWE, and it read, "So do we all just agree not to call him Gunther?" And I think that we can all agree with that. Whether WWE continue to go on with the Gunther name is unknown, although it's worth noting that the results on WWE.com appear to only refer to him as Walter, with no mention of the name change at the end of the show. But I guess we'll just have to keep tabs on that one. And finally, let's go back to All Elite Wrestling as we have some great news regarding a huge return. Last night, AEW would confirm that Jon Moxley will be making his long-awaited return tonight on Dynamite, nearly 3 months after his last appearance for the promotion. Moxley has been absent from AEW since October 2021 after he admitted himself into an inpatient rehabilitation program to help with his battle with alcoholism. His last match for the promotion came on October 27th, where he defeated the Dark Order 10 in the first round of the AEW World Title Eliminator Tournament, before Moxley was pulled and replaced by the eventual finalist, Miro. This news follows a recent announcement from GCW that their world champion was set to defend his belt in the Hammerstein Ballroom this Saturday at the World on GCW, the promotion's biggest ever event. We did speculate in a recent video that AEW would want to have Moxley's first appearance happen on one of their shows, and this now seems to be the case. As always, you can check out Moxley's GCW return using our Fight affiliate link, as well as his AEW return through AEW Plus on Fight, and again, the link is in the description. But what do you think is in store for Moxley on tonight's episode of AEW Dynamite? Let me know in the comments down below. And before you go, make sure you check out my video where I discuss 12 of the most obscure WWE appearances by AEW wrestlers.